ammunition. Travels with the Stephensons here at the Italian Festival. The Pete Wagner Band, Orchestra, Nancy James.
This will be our song before the distinguished honored guest will be honored. It's called This Moment in Time. Perfect, perfect choice. And don't forget, Revolver, Chief of Police of Newport's band, plays a lot of Beatles, 60s and 70s. Hope you enjoy them for the remainder of the night. They're playing from 8 to 11, I believe. Okay, it's a good night. Hope to ever see everybody this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Friday, the band starts off at 5 o'clock. Saturday is a killer day. We start at noon, and the same on Sunday. Monday, I die.
We know what we're doing and we have absolutely no clue. Good evening and welcome to the opening night of Italian Fest. They'll be back. You're here all weekend. There's so much more good music to come. Trust me, darling. Nancy James right here.
Way!
Is there anybody that carries a music stand better than Nancy James? No. The answer is no. I'm Gary Jeff Walker from 700 WLW. It's a pleasure to be here for my seventh year. I have absolutely no idea why I'm here because there's, as far as I've traced, in my 23 DNA.com. There's no Italian in my blood, but this is the one time of the year I get to be Italian. And it's such an honor. You know, without Italians, this place would not exist. Newport would not exist without the Italians who came here and settled in the 20th century. Hi, Robin. Robin Anderson, everybody. Right there. Give it up for Robin Anderson.
Woo!
We need the commissioners, the board of commissioners, city manager, Jessica Quitter, Moreno Frizzetti, the Italian Tom Jones. Dr. John Stevenson's already with us, ready to give his annual rendition of My Old Kentucky Home. Reverend Monsignor William Newhouse and Tom Gaduli, if you can get close to the stage, it'd be great. We'll bring you up in just a moment, and we'll get this thing started. How y'all doing tonight? Good? I'm sorry, I lived for a lot of years in Tennessee, so I can't stop from saying y'all, so forgive me for that. How y'all doing?
How y'all doing?
Good. Thumbs up. We like that. All the great food, all the great music, fireworks tomorrow night and Saturday night. A peach eating contest Saturday night at 8. We brought it back with the roses this year. That's always a joy to see. If they actually keep the pizza down. But while the band leaves the stage, we're going to leave you to your own devices. Come on up for the opening ceremonies. It's great to have you here. It's a beautiful night. It's going to be a great weekend. And again, I am so proud and honored to be a part of Newport's Italian Fest. I'm so lucky that they asked me back. Thank y'all. And of gentlemen and ladies behind me, including the man they call Cheyenne, Mayor Jerry Peluso, Vice Mayor Tom Gaduli, Commissioner Frank Peluso, Commissioner Beth Fennell, Commissioner Ken Recton, and City Manager Tom Cromie. I'd especially like to thank Tom Cromie because he said he signed a check for me. We want to begin our celebration tonight, as we always do at Italian Fest, with the Knights of Columbus Honor Guard and the Newport Police Department's Honor Guard. They'll be presenting the American and the Italian flags. Gentlemen,
here comes the honor guard. Always a great moment in the Italian festival. The proud heritage. There's my wife June and Eddie Smallwood and Ray and Darlene and Jimmy Noakes. Up from Florida, some of them. Beautiful.
DJ! Huh! Right! Face!
I'm glad to see you all on your feet. Please join me as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance of the United States of America. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We'd like to bring Jessica Quitter on to sing this country's national anthem.
So good to see you again.
Pretty good.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight
Love her too. And now
it's already running.
An Italian Fest fan favorite to sing the Italian national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Moreno Frizzetti.
Cinta la testa dove la vittoria le porga la chioma che schiava di Roma e Dio la creò. Stringiamoci a corte, san pronti alla morte, san pronti alla morte, l'Italia chiamò. Stringiamoci a corte, san pronti alla morte, san pronti alla morte, l'Italia.
We continue tonight's introduction and grand opening ceremonies with Dr. John Stephenson to pay homage to this great commonwealth we call Kentucky, we call home. Dr. John Stephenson.
Great to be here this evening with my friends from Florida, Eddie and Ray Smallwood. Of course, my wife, who's partially Italian. Everybody said she's beautiful when we were in Italy. And Jim Noakes and Darlene, my lifetime friends, all of them. We grew up together like Newport people grow up together. And Newport has the greatest mayor in the Commonwealth of Kentucky, Jerry Peluso. And I can say that because I'm the only living Kentuckian that's been in every county in the state at least 5 times and filmed the history of all 120 counties. And you also had the greatest county clerk in the Commonwealth of Kentucky, Jack Snodgrass. Let's have a big hand for him. And Jim Larrison's doing a great job. I had him on the television show the other night talking about the elections. But I'm here to sing the song that I've sang in every county in Kentucky. And it's an honor because it was taught to me by Happy Chandler back in 1968 when we got the four-year college started here in Northern Kentucky. And praise the Lord for the Northern Kentucky University. It's great for Newport and all of Kentucky, Ohio, and Indiana. And the song he taught me goes like this. The sun shines bright on my old Kentucky home. 'Tis summer, the children at play. The corn tops bright and the meadows are in bloom, and the birds make music all the day. Weep no more, my ladies. Oh, weep no more today. We will sing one song for my old Kentucky home, far my old Kentucky home, far away. Now before I sing the last verse, I want you to reach over there and touch the pulse of the person next to you, just for a moment. If they haven't got one, call the life squad. But I want you to know in that pulse, Mary, Nancy, James, bless your heart for your wonderful music. You make a joyful noise unto the Lord, and I appreciate it. And you know that song that she sang and the songs that she sings? It's like that pulse. It's the greatest gift that God gave any of us, the gift of life. And you know it knows no ethnicity, it knows no political party and no particular faith, but it does know it's the gift of life. As you reach down and touch that pulse. And the greatest gift he gave us is the gift of love. So tonight, I'm going to call upon all the citizens of Kentucky to have the love that you have when you're an Italian, because I know nobody that loves people more than Italians. Just give it up, folks. It's something that we all need to cherish. And you see a child, you reach down there and you touch him on the head and you tell him you love him. A mother, a senior, a sister, a brother, a husband and wife. And you tell him you love them. You love your friends you grew up with, you had fun with. And I love all the elected officials in Newport and in Campbell County. Oh, what a wonderful county. What wonderful people have come through here. Many years. It's really an honor to sing for you as I sing this last verse. Oh, the children roll on the little cabin floor, all merry, all happy and bright. By and by, hard times, comes a knocking at my door. Then my old Kentucky home says good night. Now join in with me. Weep no more, my lady. Home, for my old Kentucky home, far away. God bless America, and God bless Campbell County and Northern Kentucky, Ohio, and Indiana, and the Italian Festival. Praise the Lord and pass the ammunition of godly principles. Amen, brother.
I'd like to say thank you to the pianist Joe Rogers, the man behind the keyboards, keeping things tight tonight. I'd now like to bring on Reverend Monsignor William Newhouse, who is going to give the invocation tonight. Monsignor Cleves usually does this prayer, and he's in Scotland right now. So I'm the auxiliary Italian-speaking Monsignor for the diocese. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God makes known his mighty power and his abounding goodness to all the ends of the earth. But he also directs his church to bless the simplest and most commonplace things. He does so in order that all who devoutly make use of material things while invoking the name of St. Francis of Assisi may be drawn to the world that is not seen and may give glory to God, who alone performs the wonders we call miracles, but who is also wonderful in his saints. Si glorificato Signore, Dio nostro, tu che colmi delle tue benedizioni ogni creatura, concedi a quanti si nutriranno di questo cibo e questa bevanda, nel ricordo e per l'intercessione di San Francesco, di abbondare della tua grazia e di crescere nel tuo amore in una continua ricerca della realtà del cielo, per Cristo nostro Signore. E la benedizione di Dio Onnipotente, Padre, Figlio e Spirito Santo, discenda su di voi e con voi rimanga sempre. Praise God. God is great.
Amen.
I'd like to have Italian Fest Chairperson Tom Gadulli introduce a very special part of this ceremony. Mr. Gadulli, if you will, sir.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to thank the Italian Festival Committee and all the people that work to put this festival together every year, the great restaurants, the great entertainment, and all the people that work on this all year long to make this happen. Let's give them a big hand. Now, I got the honor to introduce the mayor, and the mayor, you know, is somebody that's instilled in this community, has deep roots. You might see him at Rempy Market, you might see him in your neighborhood walking and talking to one of your neighbors on an issue. You could see him on Mama Street's
sweeping the sidewalks.
Sweeping the sidewalks or picking up litter, I mean, because he takes pride in his community. The city is really, really moving forward, and I want to thank all the gentlemen and ladies that work for the city and the commissioners and the mayor. Let me introduce you, my mayor, your mayor, the mayor of the great city of Newport, Jerry Peluso.
Woo! Woo!
Woo! Morning, Sarah. First, I want to welcome you to the city that I love and proudly serve as its mayor and to our 27th Italian Fest. We have people from all over the United States come down to this festival. And I'd like to recognize someone who came all the way here this weekend. I think most of us have heard of him, from Las Vegas, Nevada, George Chicarone. George. George was a former TV news reporter here in Cincinnati. I hope I didn't embarrass you. This festival is a celebration of rich Italian heritage, its tradition, culture, food, drink, and music. We would also like to celebrate the contributions that Italian Americans have made, which have helped to make our country great. So let's celebrate. So every time I say that magic word,
celebrate, Newport.
I would like that for everyone to say with a spirit of enthusiasm, salute. Newport.
Salute.
It's a great place to live, work, shop, and play, and is the home of some of our region's most popular attractions and venues. Yes, we didn't get the soccer stadium, but hopefully this time next year, we'll have that 27-story Skywheel right in front of the three flags right behind us. Not quite as large as the one in Las Vegas, George. I think that's like 54 stories, but it's pretty tall for this area. Our success has required teamwork and has a strong sense of community. We are very fortunate to have so many partners who work with us for the benefit of the city and for the entire region. This evening provides us with an opportunity to show our appreciation to all of those who have been loyal to the city throughout the years. Thank you and enjoy all that Newport salute Italian Fest has to offer. Together, we have accomplished great things over the past several years. With your support and your participation, we will have a bright future for generations to come. So thank you. God bless the Newport salute Italian Fest, and God bless America. Thank you for being here.
The opening ceremony and all of the entertainment for this four-day festival, yeah, we're going strong till Sunday, as well as much of the operating costs are funded through our generous sponsors. I would like to just get this out of the way now, mention the sponsors. The platinum sponsors for this Italian Fest in memory of Griffin and Anna Carlisle, Capital Investment Group, Inc., Jake Sweeney Automotive, Cold Iron Concessions, Newport on the Levee, Rozzy's Famous Fireworks from the Purple People Bridge on Saturday night. You bet, Rumpke. Anchor Investment Partners, Ovation Corporex, La Rosa's Pizzeria, the gold sponsors Keating, Muthing, and CleCap PLL, Town Properties, Pompilio's, their booth right down there, the silver sponsors Crawford Insurance, IBEW Local Union 212, Seco Electric, MC Steel, and the bronze sponsors Advertiser Printers, Inc., the Mayor, Jerry Peluso, BB Riverboats, Cheryl D. Morgan Agency, the Frummy Family, Victoria Square of the Cell Group, and Tom and Jenny Gaduli. Throughout the festival grounds and in the program, which you can get easily, there's a list of those sponsors. We ask you to support those sponsors throughout the year. To put on a quality event like this requires the hard work of many volunteers. I'm reading aloud. I haven't messed up yet much. Who are listed in the program as well, the volunteers. We'd like to thank them for their efforts in the production of this great event. It takes a lot of people to put on an event that draws 120,000 people in Newport for one weekend. Let's give them all a round of applause.
Yay!
Again, fireworks tomorrow night after the Reds game and on Saturday night at 11 p.m. from the Purple People Bridge. Again, a complete schedule of these events can be picked up at the information booth. And I'd like to have the Board of Commissioners cut the ribbon. Have we got the ribbon? Do we have an imaginary ribbon?
18 Italian Fest in Newport is now officially open.
Officially open. We finally got it done. Mr. Mayor, we'd like Frank Peluso's family to come to the stage. And I'd like...
Okay. Is this great weather or not? Well, the mayor told me to say that he's a responsible for the good weather. So, it's all good. So we have a great audience tonight, we have great weather, and I think we're going to have a great event during the weekend. It's with great honor that I am privileged to introduce the honored Italian American Sons and Daughter Award this year to Mr. Frank Peluso.
Woo!
I've known Frank for a few years, and I've had the privilege of working with him, and I know where his heart's at. He bleeds Newport. He's a true Newportian. He loves his family, and I have nothing but great respect for him and his contribution to the city of Newport. Frank Thomas Peluso Sr. was born on January the 7th, 1955, just a couple of years ago, to John Jonathan and Margaret Hollerin Peluso. Frank was the grandson of Giovanni and Antonetta Peluso, both immigrants from the province of Salerno, southwest region of Italy, and the village of Lito, Italy. They arrived at Ellis Island on October the 22nd, 1913, and settled in Newport, Kentucky. He is a lifelong resident of Newport. He attended St. Stephen's Grade School and graduated from Newport Catholic High School in 1973. Frank has several certifications and training credentials. He has attained the designation as both a certified municipal clerk and certified government buyer. He is also a former member of the American Water Works Association and the National Institute of Government Purchasing. Frank was co-owners of Frankie's Catering for 20 plus years. Frankie's Catering was created because of the Newport Italian Fest. In the first few years of the Italian Fest, there weren't many Italian restaurants that wanted to participate for one reason or another. Frank always had a passion for cooking, and it was suggested that he sell his homemade ravioli and homemade sausage for the festival. That was the start of a very successful catering business. He worked for 31 years with the city of Newport in various positions, starting as a water meter reader, city clerk and purchasing agent, and ultimately the waterworks director. Frank was also a sales rep for HVAC company for 14 years. He is currently an elected official for the city of Newport and has served in the capacity as vice mayor and city commissioner. Frank had one sister, Antoinette Peluso Kunkel, who unfortunately passed away in August of 1990.